haven't posted on my vlog channel in forever. That's just because I've been lazy. Yes, I've been lazy. I'm just going to talk about relationships right now again because I had this talk with you guys a couple, like, over the winter. And it was, like, really nice to connect with you guys. It was really nice. I know you guys liked it because I got a lot of views on that. And I'm just going to be talking about, I don't know, just kind of, like, I don't even know right now. I didn't put anything down. I don't have notes. I just got done filming. And as soon as I got done filming, I was like, I want to make a hair tutorial. I mean, I want to talk on my vlog, do an update on how I'm doing. There's times where I still miss him, and it really sucks sometimes because I'm just like, well, like, I was still in love with him till, like, the last of the last. Like, why did he, like, stop loving me and stuff like that? And it's just kind of hard for me to understand that and comprehend that and actually, like, sink that in even after all the closures and after everything, because after all, he was still playing with my head and put hearts on my Facebook wall and just, like, call me and stuff like that. And he kind of just, like, I think he just wanted to keep me around because he knew how I felt about him. And it's just kind of, like, weird to ever even think that, like, he's over me, because in my head, I thought we were, like, going to be together forever. And sometimes I still think that it kind of replay in my head, like, the times that we had together and the times that we should have had together and how it should have gone sometimes. But I know that everything for me and him is for the better. We weren't always happy, and I kind of tried to make people think we had the perfect relationship, but in reality, the truth of my relationship, it wasn't even all that good. There's a lot of arguing, there's a lot of breakups, there's a lot of cursing, there's a lot of insults. It was just kind of like we just dragged along with it until we could, because I was the one that really did, like, love him, but he just wanted to be like, oh, well, I was in a relationship for 2 years and crap like that. He just wanted to keep me around as long as he could so he could brag about it. And that's why he kind of got over me really quickly. You know, it was just kind of, like, weird. He just wanted, I don't know, his intentions were, I'm not in his mind, even though we were together for so long. I can't figure him out. I never could figure him out. I don't try to figure him out because it's just not gonna happen. So I don't know, like, I think when I got over him was when we met up, and, you know, that's when I talked about you guys about, I talked to you guys about it last time. That was, like, my beginning steps. It's been 6 months since then, and I think I'll do a 6 month update every single thing, because a lot of people go through breakups and they don't know how to deal with it, and I didn't know how to deal with it. So if I had someone talking to me about it, like, step by step, even though not every single relationship is the same, I would be happy, and I would have had a general idea of how relationships go and how guys think. Right now, I don't think I want a relationship. I just want to have fun, because, like, my whole time, my heart has been taken by something, like, even though we weren't together, like, with him. My heart was taken for 3 years since I was been single. And then the other months, I was taken by somebody else who I thought I liked a lot, but I really didn't. It was just kind of a thing to get over him and just be like, well, I love him and not him, so I must be over him. That happens when you get in relationships. You tend to want other people. You tend to force yourself to want other people, when in reality, you just don't. You just want them, but you want people to think, oh, she's over him, because you complain too much about your relationship, because that's what I did. It was just kind of hard, how he was always putting himself out there to other girls, and I was just like, why? Like, why are you doing that? Why don't you just focus on one thing? And he fell in love more times, so I was just kind of, like, heartbroken, and I know I'm still not fully over him. I know I'm mostly over him because I don't think about him every day, and I'm okay with not being with him, like, as I've been for a long time. I think sometimes I just miss the relationship we had, like, just being like, oh, he cares, and I just kind of can't explain everything because, like, I don't know, it's just unexplainable. Everybody feels differently, and I feel different than others, and how I feel, people are looking at me like, like, okay, it's been 3 years, but sometimes it's just, like, I can't help it. Like, I look at myself like that sometimes, too, like, Anna, it's been 3 years. Like, you have to get over him. I think you don't get over someone completely until you're in a relationship with somebody else and you really, truly do love him or her. It's just kind of hard. Everything is so jumbled up right now, and that's how it is in my head. Like, there's so many questions that need to be answered for me, from him, but I know they won't because everything's just different now. But I don't know, I just feel like he's a cool person and I wish I could be friends with him, but I can't be friends with him because feelings start coming back, even if they're not love feelings. Like, one of us get mad at each other because of what we did to each other in the relationship. Like, I'm not gonna say that he just treated me bad, because I treated him bad too, and we did stuff that we shouldn't have done, like cheated, for instance. We both cheated. He cheated on me. I cheated on him. I cheated on him like 3 times, but not really. Like, I was just flirting with other people because he was flirting with his girlfriend, ex-girlfriend, and I just kind of wanted not to be the jealous girlfriend to him, and I just wanted to get back at him, and just without him knowing. He cheated on me like 12 times. So yeah, it was just kind of like weird. The one time he knew, like, we were kind of like breaking up, so it was just kind of like that kind of thing. And I don't know, like, why we kept being in the relationship. It was hard to see each other because we were so young and he left. I don't know, I just always think about him sometimes. It's like what we could have been, and there's so many questions that I need to be answered, but like I said, they're not gonna be answered, and so I'm just always gonna think what ifs. Right now we would have been together because we were supposed to get back together when we were 18, but that didn't happen. I'm not 18, yeah, I'm still 17, but he's 18, so I don't know, I think we kind of just molded into each other, being separate, because he's good without me, and I guess I'm good without him, too. Right now, I just want to be single. I just want to mess with guys. I don't know, like, I've been played too many times. Like, I don't want to play anyone, because I know I have it in me to get back at people, and I hold grudges. And I do hold grudges, like, against him. More so, resentment for everything that we've been through together. Why is this phone looking weird? Right there. More so resentment than anything, but that tends to happen, right? If I could say anything to him right now, it would be good luck in college and to keep his head grounded, to be humble, to never lose his passion for football, because I think that's what he's going to college for. Not to let girls get in the way for him, because boyfriends always attract people. Like, being in a relationship, the other gender, whatever, if you're gay, the same gender, whatever, you're a significant other, they always tend to distract you, because especially if you're doing a sport, you know, you need to be dedicated to football. You have practices. I mean, not football, just your sport. You have practices. You have to, you know, you're tired all the time. You have to do this kind of stuff. And, you know, your other significant other wants to see you all the time. And it's just going to be hard to do that when you're always tired and you're always so sore. And you can't really, you don't want to go out and do stuff. You just want to kind of lay in and stuff like that. It's hard like that, and you have practices at all kinds of times, so you don't see them, and then you don't talk to them, and then it's just really hard. So you always have to keep grounded until you have your dreams come true. You want to not really be in a relationship, not get focused on other girls, just stay focused on your dream and your goal. And I think that I know you have potential to be, you know, what you want to be, and good luck. As for me, like, I just think I'm just gonna be doing YouTube videos for a long time because that's what I want to do and go to beauty school and probably stay single for as long as I can. My plans for the future, I just want to, my plans for having kids have gone. I don't want to have kids because giving birth is really scary. I want to be, to still live in this house in the same room. So as long as I can, I don't want to rush, this looks really disgusting. I don't want to rush into being a grown up because that's not fun. I don't know, I just want to work at a hair salon and move my way up and work hard on what I love. Probably before my plans were to get married at 19, to have kids and move out. Right now, I just don't want to do that. I just want to stay here. The oldest I'll probably stay here is 22. And I won't get married, and I'm going to adopt kids, so, I mean, I will get married now. That's the only thing that's another thing that has changed, because I want to adopt kids now, and I can't adopt or be a foster mom if I don't, get married. So, I just want to say, fuck that rule, because now I don't like labels, now I need a label, so I can do something and adopt a child and help a child out, which that's really fucking retarded. Yeah, so this is my senior year, and I have 5 classes, and I leave at 11:30, so I hope I get a job because I don't want to come home and do nothing. I'd rather be in school, honestly. If anything, if I could wake up later, that'd just be awesome, but I can't, so that sucks. And that is all.